Hey, my name is Daniel, and today you will learn how to set up your digital mixer for multi-track recording and virtual sound check. Let's go! I will use a Midas M32 in this video, but the same concept applies with any kind of live mixer. The only difference would be how the routing menu looks with different brands. Type A to type B USB cable. Plug it into the back of the mixer, turn it on, and plug it into your computer. First thing we will do is go to the setup menu, all the way to card, and here we will choose the configuration of inputs and outputs. I like to keep them all active, so I will keep 32 in, 32 out. Now we will go to the routing menu, and as you can see, the channels are in blocks of 8. And there's also a record mode and a play mode. This menu might be a little bit confusing, but here's how it works. On the input page, local means the XLR inputs on the back of the console. So we're gonna tell the mixer that channels 1 to 8 get local 1 to 8, 9 to 16 get local 9 to 16. If you're not plugged into the back of the console or you're using a stage box or digital snake, it will be AES50 1 to 8. AS59 to 16, etc. Now we're done with the recording part, but before we go to the computer, we're gonna configure the playback inputs. Go to play mode, and we're gonna tell the mixer that channels 1 to 8 are getting their inputs from card 1 to 8. Channels 9 to 16 from card 9 to 16. Before we start recording, make sure that the project file and the console are running at the same sample rate. This is very important, or else the recording will be basically unusable. So you're gonna go to setup and check the sample rate. If it's 48 kHz, create your project in 48 kHz. If it's 44.1, create your project in 44.1. If you're using a Windows machine, you're most likely gonna have to install a driver called ASIO4ALL V2. So now we are in Reaper. Go ahead and press Ctrl P to open the preferences. Make sure that the ASIO driver is selected. Go ahead and click ASIO configuration. Activate the M32 USB, which is the sound card of the mixer. Click OK. Open the preferences again. Set the first input and the last input so they all show up. Same thing to the outputs. First output, last output. So all the inputs and outputs are showing now. Make sure the sample rate is the same as the console. You can also check request sample rate so you make sure that the project is running at the same sample rate of the console. Hit OK. Now we're gonna create new tracks, but instead of creating them one by one, we will go ahead and insert multiple tracks. Let's say 16. Now we're gonna assign inputs and outputs for each track, but doing it like this takes a lot of time. So what we'll do is press Alt R, it will open a routing matrix. These are the tracks that we created, 1 to 18. And this means that we're sending them to the master output. So we're gonna uncheck those. And these are the recording inputs. So we're gonna give channel 1, the first input on the card. Channel 2, the second input. Third, fourth, you get the idea. And these are the outputs. So track 1 gets output 1 on the card. Track 2, output 2, you get the idea. Now go back to routing and put it in play mode. Now the tracks are going back into the mixer. And now you can do your virtual sound check. If this was helpful, make sure to give it a thumbs up, subscribe, and if you have any questions, ask me in the comments below, and I'll see you in the next video. Whew.